A TSBVI Outreach Tutorial. APH Braille Print Protractor, Part 5. Drawing a Print 90 Degree Angle. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Math Consultant.
Okay, we're going to now go ahead and draw an angle using the APH Braille Print Protractor. And the first thing I'm going to suggest, at least what I've got here, is some canary yellow paper, because for a lot of my students that particular color paper helps with the contrast. So either they could put their paper on a table, just like I have, or they may prefer to be under a CCTV doing this. So either way, whatever works for them is the best way. Probably the larger CCTV rather than the smaller portable one, so that they do have, if they have both. The use of both hands, they're going to be able to use both of their hands. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pretend that the teacher has assigned them the job of drawing a 90 degree angle. Okay, so first of all, they have some vision, but perhaps they like that tactile feedback, and I would really encourage tactile feedback even for our low vision students, even if they have a lot of vision. Now, hopefully they do have an idea that 90 degree angle is going to have three dots. So they might say, well, that's about halfway and I think I'm almost there. Ah, okay, yes, I can feel those three dots. I do see the 90. I'm going to line that up, really get that. And I'm going to tell you, those dots will really help them, I think, lining up. Otherwise, if they're not doing this, their head may be way down on top of it, and this way you're going to kind of be able to look over their shoulder too to see what's happening. They'll be in a much more comfortable their posture and so forth. Okay, so they think they've got their 90 degree angle, and then as we mentioned, they're going to turn it basically upside down. They have their angle formed, and here's one thing. They've got an angle of 90 degrees on this side, but remember that the supplement is also there, which is 90 degrees. So they could make a choice. They could draw it on this side or this side. And I'm just because I'm right-handed, it's going to be easier for me to do it, go ahead and draw the angle that's on my right side. So I'm going to go and show you that technique. But remember, your student, especially if they are left-handed instead of right-handed, might do just the opposite. Whatever their technique, as long as it works, that's what you're going to want them to use. So I will show you my technique, though, and that is really holding that wand down very firmly with my thumb and my other fingers. And in fact, I'm going to probably put my whole hand and really give it some weight there. And what I'm going to be very careful to do, and let's watch this area. This is what students do a lot. They mess up, not quite this dramatic, but they will accidentally get a little bit of their finger in this area. So that's another thing, is to really show them, be sure that your finger is out of that drawing area. And then they can just grab, let's say I'm just going to grab a ballpoint pen, because that always seems to be around, and go ahead, and this is what you're going to do. Just that with that edge against the wand, come down. You can tactually feel it if they want to do that, or visually, and then across, and they have just made a 90 degree angle. Now up here I didn't press quite as much, and I have a very cheap ballpoint pen. I'm going to go ahead and practice a little bit, and that might be what they want to do as well. They might want to go ahead and practice a few of those and say, okay, I'm ready now. I think I know how to do this. I'm going to go ahead and hand this one in to the teacher. I've got my technique down. Okay, so they've drawn their angle. The teacher may have said, be sure to put little arrow endings on showing that the rays that form that angle continue forever. So they might want to put some arrows. The teacher might say, be sure to mark it with 90 degrees. So they might want to say 90 degrees. The teacher might, or they might decide, hey, you know, there's another way to do that, and that's by putting a little right angle box. Okay, all different kinds of things. And then, of course, they're going to want to put their name on their paper. And I'm just going to put it very simply. They have their instructions as to how they are supposed to do it. But basically, this is ready to go to the teacher now. Okay, so that's all there really is to it. You go ahead and select that measurement, point the wand to it, tighten down, turn upside down, and draw. That's how you draw, in this case, a 90 degree angle.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, APH Braille Print Protractor. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on Math for the Blind and Visually Impaired. APH is American Printing House for the Blind. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Program. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756, USA. Telephone 512-454-8631. Website www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2009, all rights reserved.